Hi children, come we'll see the next topic, circle. Okay, circle, take your textbook, take page number 138. Okay, 138. Now we are going to learn about circle. Okay, come we'll see about that. See, this is a circle that we know. Okay, circle. See, in this, the point which is at the center is called center. Okay, center, point O is the center of the circle. All the points on the circle are at the same distance from the center of the circle. See, all the points, if you take all the points on the circle, see this line, no, on the circle, this is a circle. This is a circle. All the points on the circle are at the same distance from the center. Okay, this is the center, O is the center. If you take any point on the center, it will be on same distance from the center. Understood, children? So it will be same distance from the center. Okay, if you take any point on the circle, it will be same distance from the circle. Chord. Next is chord. What is chord? Segment AB is a chord of the circle. If you take the line segment, you know, no, that will have a definite length and two end points. That is the AB. Here the line segment, segment AB is the chord of the circle. What is this chord? A chord is a segment which joins any two points on the circle. Okay, any two points on the circle. If you draw a circle and if you take any points on the circle, okay, that part, that is the chord. AB is the chord. Okay, look here children, this is a circle. Okay, and the point here, no, this is the center point. Okay, and the distance, the point, if you take any point on the circle, see, on the circle, the distance from the point to that point on the circle will be what? Same. Okay, and see here, what is the what? Chord that we saw, no, chord. This is the chord, no? See, if you take any two points, see, I am going to take any two point. If I taking here on this circle, I am taking P, okay, this is one point, and here I am taking here Q, okay, Q. See, any here also you can take, here also you can take, here also, anywhere you can take. And if you join those two points, okay, join those two points, that is called the chord. What it is called? Chord. What it is called? Chord. Okay. So chord is nothing but the line, that is a segment, okay, which joins any two points on the circle. Understood, children? This is a chord and O is the center. Okay. And come, we'll see the next thing, that is nothing but the radius. Radius. See, what is radius? Segment OP, okay, is a radius of the circle. Radius is a segment which joins the center of the circle and any point on the circle. Okay. So, which joins? It's a line segment which has two end points, O and P. Okay. So, that is a segment which joins the center and any point on the circle. Come, I'll draw the radius. Look here, this is the center. Okay. So, we want radius. So, it is a segment which joins any point you take, like that Q R you take, this R. Okay, and if you draw a line between the center and the arc, okay, that is the radius. Okay, that is the segment which joins the center and any point on the what? Circle, which is called radius. What we call it as? Radius. Understood, children? Okay, so this radius will be what? Of same length. If you take any point on the circle and you join it with the center, the length will be what? Equal. Okay, the radius will be equal all over the wherever you take the point on the circle, and if you connect it to the center, the radius will be equal. Okay, come, we will see the next one, that is nothing but the, go to next page children, diameter. What? Diameter. Diameter, what is it? Segment CD, look here, segment CD is a diameter of the circle. A diameter is a chord of the circle which passes through the center of the circle. Okay. So, what is this word? Diameter. It's also a line segment. It's also what? It is nothing but a chord. Chord is nothing but the line joins two points on the circle, but it is passes through the center. but this chord is passes through the center. Okay, see, I'll show you. See here, this is the circle, no? Come, I'll show you the what diameter. See, we know diameter is the nothing but the line. Okay, you can take like this also. If you take two points, look here. See, it passes through the center. So it passes through the center. Okay, so what's the line? If you take this point as A and this point as B, it is also a line segment. Okay, that is a chord which passes through the what center? That is the diameter. What diameter? Understood, children? Okay. It can pass through like this also. You can draw one more diameter like this. Okay, you can draw. Okay, so many diameters you can draw. Okay. So a diameter is the longest chord of the circle. Okay, the longest chord of the circle. Length of a diameter is twice the length of radius of a circle. Because see here, if you take, it is nothing but the length. Okay, twice the length of radius. Look here, from center to. See here, children. If you take, look here, from, see, if you take one radius, it will start from what, the center to any point on the circle, and here also it will starts from center to any point on the circle. So what, the diameter is nothing but the what is twice the length of the radius of a circle. Okay, see, two radius are there here, from center to this point, from center to this point. So two radius are there. So diameter is nothing but twice the length of the radius of a circle. Okay, a diameter divides the circle into two equal parts. Okay, and also this diameter divides the circle into two equal parts. Okay, which each part is called semicircle. Okay, each part is called semicircle. Look here, children, this is the circle, and see here, see, if you cut it, see, the diameter makes it into two halves. Okay, see here, if you, this is the diameter. Okay, and it makes the circle into two halves, which is called the semicircle. Each part, this part is called what? This is a semicircle. Half of the circle is called semicircle, and this portion is called what? Diameter of the circle. Understood? See here, this is the semicircle. Okay, semicircle. Look here, this is a circle. If you cut the circle into two halves, you will get semicircle. Okay, understood? Assignment 8. Come, we'll see the assignment. Complete the table by writing the corresponding radii. Okay, radii is nothing but the plural of radius. Okay, radius, radii. See, if you take for example apple, apples. Okay, so that's the plural of what? Radius is radii, or diameters of circles. So we should write the, we know what, diameter is nothing but twice the length of the radius. Okay, understood, children? So come, we'll see that. So that is diameter. What's the formula here? Diameter is equal to 2 into radius. Okay, 2 into radius. Okay, and what? So that we can find the what? Radius and diameter using this formula. So, and also we know radius is equal to diameter by 2. Okay, say for the, come, we'll do the assignment sum. Radius 5 centimeter. Okay, so what is the diameter? 2 into 5, 10 centimeter. See here, the second one, diameter is given here 16 centimeter. We want what? Radius, no? See, 16 centimeter. Radius is half of the diameter. So 16 by 2, that is nothing but 8 centimeter. Okay, here also the diameter is given. We want radius. We know radius is nothing but what? Diameter by 2, that is 3 centimeter is the radius. Okay, see, 4 centimeter is the radius. We want diameter. So what is the diameter? 2 into radius, that is nothing but 8 centimeter is the radius. So in this way you can find the remaining sums. Okay, radius, if radius is given, you can find the diameter. If diameter is given, you can find the radius using this formula. Okay, children, come, we'll see the next topic, that is nothing but what? Symmetry. Okay, symmetry. What is symmetry? If a figure can be folded along a line such that the two parts fall exactly over each other, we say that the two parts exactly coincide with each other. Okay, the figure is called a symmetrical figure and the line is called a line of symmetry or an axis of symmetry. Okay, see here, I'll show you one figure that we will see in our next video, children, about symmetry. I'll show you examples and all. Okay.